In today's video, we are going to look at core exercises for hip impingement rehab. Get our very own assessment ebook and mobile app. Links are in the video description. Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. In 2016, 25 clinical societies from all over the world got together to form the Warwick Agreement, a consensus statement on hip impingement, also known as femoroacetabular impingement or FAI, which among other topics included the suggested rehab for the condition. They all agreed that conservative care may involve education, watchful waiting, lifestyle and activity modification. Physiotherapy-led rehabilitation should aim to improve hip stability, neuromuscular control, strength, range of motion, and movement patterns. There's no clear-cut rehab protocol, as the exercise program should be tailored to the demands of the individual, and we are still awaiting the results of multi-center RCTs comparing conservative with surgical rehab for the condition. One of those RCTs by Wall et al. Just published their results, which state that patients improved after physiotherapy as well as surgery, but with significantly and clinically relevant outcomes in the surgical group. They performed at least 6 one-on-one treatment sessions over a minimum period of 12 weeks. In the first part of this video series, we are going to look at their proposed core exercises.
For the first exercise, ask the patient to sit on a gymnastics ball and then ask them to gently move the pelvis forwards and backwards, side to side, and in circles. The second exercise is the abdominal exercise. Ask the patient to lie on their back with the legs slightly bent. Then ask them to draw the belly button down towards the spine whilst keeping the pelvis still and maintaining normal breathing. For the next stability exercise, the patient lies in supine hook-lying position. Then they perform the same maneuver as in the abdominal exercise. Consequently, instruct the patient to let one leg fall outwards while keeping the heel on the ground. The patient only lets the leg move outwards as far as trunk control allows and moves back to the starting position. Continuing on, you could have the patient lie on their back with the knees bent and the feet slightly apart. Keeping control over the trunk as in the abdominal exercise, the patient lifts the pelvis until the knees, hips and shoulders are level and holds the position for a couple of seconds depending on their capacity and then slowly relaxes. As with all of the exercises, the time in seconds for the hold as well as repetitions are individualized. Additionally, one leg can be extended at the top position to increase the difficulty of this exercise. For the next exercise, the patient lies prone with the hips and back relaxed and one leg is bent so that the foot faces the ceiling. Instruct the patient to tighten their lower stomach muscles and to gently squeeze both glutes to flatten the lower back. Whilst holding this contraction, the patient is asked to lift the bent leg 5 cm off the ground, paying attention not to let the back arch or pelvis twist, as the focus is on movement in the hip joint. In another exercise from the protocol, the patient lies in supine hook-lying position with the legs bent and one leg is bent further up so that the foot is in the air. The patient is again asked to maintain a neutral lower back throughout the exercise. Then instruct the patient to slowly slide the other leg out, keeping the heel on the floor and only as far as trunk control allows before returning to the starting position. The next exercise is called the clam. The patient is in side-lying position with the hips flexed to around 45 degrees and the knees bent. Leaving the heels together, the patient is asked to slowly lift the top knee by turning the hip out without letting the back or pelvis twist. As we are focusing on movement in the hip joint, the patient should only move the hip out as far as a stable back and pelvis allow. You can use a TheraBand or elastic loop to make the exercise harder. Another exercise that can be done in side lying position is the following. Ask the patient to bend the bottom leg back while the top leg is held straight. The trunk should be kept stable, as in the previous exercises. Then the patient brings the top leg back and slightly up before performing external rotations. The patient holds this position for a few seconds before slowly rotating back. Let's look at a weight-bearing stability exercise. The patient is going to stand on both legs with their weight over the midfoot, so to not letting the pelvis sway forwards. Then they gently squeeze the glutes and are asked to lift one foot behind them. Whilst keeping the shoulder and pelvis level, they slowly turn the body away from the leg they are standing on. Focus on keeping the pelvis leveled and the glutes remain tight. A great way to train disassociation of hip joint from trunk movements are bird dogs. The patient will be in 4-point kneeling position with a relaxed neutral back. Then instruct the patient to slowly straighten the hip and knee to lift the leg out behind them and to slightly contract the glutes during the leg lift. They should avoid arching the back or twisting of the pelvis, so the leg will only lift as far as a stable back allows. For this last exercise, the patient is standing with the back against a wall. Then they are instructed to slide down the wall about 6 to 8 inches whilst keeping the back against the wall.
These are the core exercises included in the protocol. Check part 2, where we cover the included strength exercises by clicking or tapping on the left. Please subscribe to our channel if you haven't yet and hit the bell icon next to it to get notified when we post new videos. Check the video description down below for a handful of useful links, for example, to our other social media channels. And as always, this was Andreas for Physiotutors. I'll see you next time. Bye.